up guys, welcome back to another YouTube video. As you can see, I'm at Narita Airport right now. I'll be flying from Tokyo to Paris today for a business trip to Paris to attend Paris Fashion Week as a representative of GQ Taiwan. It's actually my first ever Fashion Week, so I am really excited and I am really grateful to have the opportunity to attend the shows. So guys, without further ado, let's go. Morning guys, how's it going? It's my big day today, the 23rd of June. I'm going to 5 shows today, ranging from Issey Miyake, Louis Vuitton, Prisma Note 10, Namesake, and as you might have already guessed, according to what I'm wearing, Rick Owens. So yeah, actually, what really sucks is that Louis Vuitton, like their invitation, so they're supposed to send me like a physical invitation too, I think, but then like it didn't arrive in time. So like I got my ones from Dior, I got my ones from Louis Vuitton. Well, like matter of fact, like actually let me show you those invitations. But like the one from Louis Vuitton like just didn't arrive somehow. And I don't know what should I do. Maybe I should just go up to the show and then tell them my name, whatnot. Cause I know like the traditional ways that you take the invitation with you and then like they let you in. That's usually how it works. So anyways guys, this is the invitation from Dior. Let me open it for you guys. Really beautiful. It's like the Dior monogram on the inside. So I'm thinking that, you know, well, it's not just I'm thinking that, it's quite obvious that this season, like the theme is going to be something about flowers. So that's why like they sent me like a packet of seeds, it's me, my name, and you know, some other stuff. Menswear show, Dior, Kim Jones, and this is something from Amiri. So unfortunately, I wouldn't be able to attend the show because it's 4 o'clock this evening and I have to go to the other show, which is Namesake, which leads us to our next invitation. So Namesake is actually a Taiwanese brand, which is, you know, from my hometown. I've wrote some articles for them. Matter of fact, I think their first collection I was handling their press release. That's back when I was interning in GQ. Yeah, so anyways, you see Polo Chan. Wait, should I bring this? I have no idea. Like this, I think this is the invitation and somehow like you can probably cut it out and then you can make it into a basketball, I think. But yeah, like I really do love this brand. They're so ahead of their time. Like everything they create is amazing. Like they don't look like they're trying too hard. Like everything they make is like extremely fashionable. And then like the style is just amazing. I think the boys are from Necessity Sense and you know like they incorporate like Taiwanese culture into these stuff, so I'm like super proud of them, even though like they probably don't know me, but you know I'm just super excited to see the show. This their first ever Paris Fashion Week, is like their Paris Fashion Week debut show, and then like they blessed me with a lot of stickers. I personally like, let me find my favorite. Yeah, my favorite's this, it's their logo, super nice. Probably put it on my MacBook, whatnot. And yeah, and then like the other one, so most of them are like e-invitations, but like this one is from Loewe, I think. So the plant belongs inside here. So I was quite shocked when I got this, you know. I was like on a bridge and I was like putting my hand in, like trying to grasp what that is. And then like I touched that and then, you know, like it's in the dark, right? So I was like terrified, like what kind of a fucking creature is inside. But then like it turns out it's just some harmless plant and then it's really cute. What I really do like about this is this part. So this is like a pin and it has like the Loewe logo on it. Looks super nice. I really like how, you know, when brands, they do like creative stuff, you know, not just a letter, but you know, some plants or like, you know, Louis Vuitton back then they have like clocks or whatnot. So yeah, these stuff like really gets me really excited about these shows. And then I have like another one in my pocket right now. Yeah, so this is the, again, I have to cover up my address. It's the Issey Miyake one. So this is going to be their first show in 2 years. I actually haven't opened it up. Let me open it up right now. All right, here we go. Issey Miyake, Spring Summer 23 Collection, Paris Fashion Week 11:30. That's my seat number, AB33. So yeah, really nice. I have to keep this in my pocket. I think that they will check the invitation when I arrive, so it's important to have it. And yeah, guys, I think it's about time for me to head out to the Issey show. Until line here, you know, other people after a show, or like when they're going from a show to another, they take Uber. But I don't take Uber. I just slime everywhere I go, you know? Like a real Parisian, you know? I have 5 shows to attend today, so it really is my big day. Super excited. I hope I can make it to all the shows. I hope no shows are delayed so I can make it to all of them. Ricked up and ready to go. Yo, here we go. Beautiful stage, huh? Hey guys, so I just found my seat. Second row is not too bad. The show's called Flowers and Vases. An exploration of the contrast between what is delicate and what is robust. I'm really looking forward to this. Haven't had a show in a while. Issey Miyake is really cool. And then at the back, show credits, whatnot. I hope it doesn't get delayed. I don't want to miss the rickshaw. Yo, you can't believe it. You know, I almost fucked it up, but I'm here. What a line here, 4 kilometers.
Wait a minute, been aquí, c'est la vie. I tell the whole truth from A to Z. Show me you real, show me that you bleed.
Really, are you happy for me? Smile on my face, yeah. But are you happy for me? Yeah. I'm out the way. Are you happy for me?
by their tongues and rap lyrics, scared to be crucified by the song, but they won't admit it. Politically correct, cause how you keep an opinion. Niggas is tight, and the fuck will get to be different. See the Christians say the vaccine mark. Then I caught COVID and started to question Kyrie. Will I stay organic or hurt this bear for 2 weeks? Do you want peace?
Guys, I just got off the Louis Vuitton show, and then now I'm at getting ready for my namesake show. I lined everywhere because there's nowhere to get a taxi, and then a taxi is slowly online apparently. So yeah, really, really tired now. The Louis Vuitton show was great though. It's kind of Lamar Marson, and like I swear to God, I know this. Like the first Virgil, he said like I literally said to like the lady sitting beside me, is that Kendrick Lamar? And then it is. So man, I can really get that happening now. And then like when I exit Louis Vuitton, Kendrick was literally walking behind of me, and then like I was like, everyone's snapping photos. I'm like, I'm not a celebrity, but then like Kendrick Lamar is there. Like, so for the very guys who know me pretty well, you know that Kendrick Lamar to me is like literally my everything. Like since I'm 12, like when people ask me who's my favorite artist, I never said anyone else's name. It's always Kendrick Lamar. So like really happy. I mean, like to enter the Louis Vuitton show was quite a drag. It was kind of like a bad experience, but like the show itself was really good. I'm so stressed out right now. I'm so tired. I have like 3s later today, right after this. So I'll see how it goes, man. I try to film stuff, but I'm just really tired. Just got my ticket from my friend because I got it shipped to her place. So here we are. It's the Dries Van Noten show. Seems like it's taking place in a BMW parking lot or something like that. Yeah, it's like a parking lot. Yeah, it's pretty cool because, like, you know, the other shows are mostly, I mean, like, at least for this season, they're mostly located in central Paris. And this one's just really, it's kind of like far away, I'll say. But it looks like it feels pretty promising so far. It's really different. I'm really looking forward to what kind of show we're putting on. Thinking that, you know, if Dries is going to be doing crazy stuff like 2014 again for menswear, it's going to be really cool. And so far, you know, this industrial aesthetic kind of suggests that they're going to do something that's industrial, military, whatnot. At least that's what I'm looking forward to. I can be completely wrong though.
I took my jacket off, it's like probably worse, and I thought this made the most of it. Yeah.
Oh, guys, after climbing, I'd say 4 or 5 floors, I finally arrived. Dries Van Noten. Guys, I'm at the Louis Vuitton Reese now. I was super tired yesterday, so I didn't film anything when I got home, and I have like so many work, so
Anyways, I'm going to film something at the Louis Vuitton Reese's, and since everyone's filming something, this is a smoothie from Louis Vuitton. It's pretty decent. I didn't understand the word on like the ingredients. I only understand like citron. I think that means lemon in French, but whatever. What a time to be alive. Yeah, let's see. I think this is like a smaller imitation of the stage the other day. Bucket hat, sneakers. Let me get a closer look of this. Cool. New Louis Vuitton shoes. Seems like there's like an inner socket. It's pretty nice. Double knee, Carhartt look-alike, Vuitton monogram denim. Decent bags. Some snowboarding shoes, right? It's still like the imitation of the Vuitton trainer, which is an imitation of Jordan 4, I believe. The colorway, I think at the show I thought it was some, you know, Timberland imitation, but it turns out to be some ski shoes. Very, very amazing leather. Great stuff, great stuff. The puffer. There was like a similar one, a black version. It's more stiff. This is like more softer, the whole structure. Pretty nice. I think this one is the look that the most people are talking about, the trousers. And like denim, not like a white project look-alike trousers, but yeah, curvy, really nice. The shoes also is like the huge shoes with like the sockets. This belt over here, amazing. Necklace, hat, not bad. Great look, actually. I can't seem to find the one with like the paper plank flying all over like the jacket. I thought that was the one that people would be like really looking forward to. Oh, here we go. There's like another one, another colorway. These are definitely going to be all over Instagram, I'll say. Oh, like the matching color of, you know, the shoes matches the bag, matches the other bag. Varsity jackets. Yes. 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 I can definitely see some Virgil influence on this. Yeah. Oh, this is pretty nice. I'll actually wear this. Decent colorway. Decent design. Pretty minimal. This is cute, but I can see this on Instagram. This, I'll give my honest opinion, this doesn't look too good. This kind of look a little bit too Versace than Louis Vuitton to me. And then like, the leather quality is okay, but then, Let me know about your thoughts. Okay, here we go, another rack. Starting off with some leather jacket. Ooh, these are really nice. The quality is amazing. This, like the zipper. Oh my God, this is actually pretty impressive. Yeah, this is really good. Another double knee. Okay, okay. More deconstructed style. Minimalistic stuff, I guess. Not bad, not bad. These. Personally, I'll never wear it, but I can see this on celebrities. It's going to look pretty nice when they go to award shows in these. For the windbreaker itself, I think it's all right. Not too good, not too bad. Then the hood, really nice. Kind of reminds me of the Solus aesthetic, but you know, a little twist of the Walter Van Baron Donk and the two big spikes. It's pretty good. Like, this hood literally makes this whole fit so much better. that is. Oh, it's like a chain. That's like the zipper that we saw earlier. Absolutely amazing. Look at this. Big ups to Louis Vuitton.